How's it going, everyone? I'm Contemption, and today we're in 2396. We are doing Marauders right now, so we are on stage 3 of Eve of the Crusade. I'm just going to finish off the base rewards, 400,000 individual points, so that I can get the gems, the teleport, and the speed up. Why not? I could use that. I'm also getting a lot of goodies, obviously, from Marauder Forts. Then I gotta jump back onto Barbarians, only because I still have 2 levels to complete my Bunny Bonanza event. Obviously want those 15 legendary commander sculptures and the 2,000 gems back. I'm not going to get the 4th column, but you know what? These goodies to finish level 25 is an absolute must. So we're just going to go over this. We're going to open up a bunch of crystal keys. I've got a lot laying around. I am hopeful, fingers crossed, maybe we can get Shio's Boots or the Hope Cloak would be phenomenal. Even Eternal Knight would be nice. I believe you can get that from there. Let's see, we got the Hope Cloak we can definitely get. We can get Eternal Knights and we can get Shio's Return. So maybe we'll get lucky. If we do, I could hopefully craft one of them today and then put an iconic crystal in there and be set for this KvK Light versus Dark. Very excited about it. Yes, the runes only get one march, but I'll be able to use Alex and YSG. He's nothing fantastic, but 551, and we got more sculptures coming up, so hopefully 5513 would be awesome before we have to fight. I think that would be great. It's definitely good enough, as long as I can not get pulled into the murder balls. But let's get through the intro. We are going to open a bunch of things, go over this account, see how it's going to do, and hopefully get these kills raised up, because right now my kills on this account are pretty sad, and we've got to switch civilization. So hopefully Lilith releases that other civilization soon. I believe it's going to be Egypt. I don't know. I saw something on Facebook earlier, but I didn't have time to read it. So here we go. Let's get through the intro and jump into it. Okay, so we've got, do we have any more right now? No, I'm launching some. I'm joining as many that pop up. I've got 5 marches free for Marauders until we finish this. So we will jump in and out of that. Of course, collect some of those. I want to finish that. Like I said yesterday during my long video, I wait till 100, then I open them. It's just force of habit. I don't know why. This account has a good amount of resources saved up. I've got over 100 million of each up top. A lot of gold. I'll be able to help whales heal their T5. I don't need that much gold. I just obviously get it from the beautiful mother lode that sits beside me all the time. Very grateful for that. I will be able to help people, and that's all that matters. I didn't do recharge on this account. Too expensive to do it on 2 accounts, in my opinion. And this account will just have to progress naturally. It does, of course, get the supply depot. I do get the 30-day gem supply as it runs out. No point in doing recharge with it because you need more than this purchase anyways. And I also do, like I've said many times before, Lucerne Scroll. Absolute must. It's $5 for the Treasure Hunter bundle. It is phenomenal. You can't beat the value on this. You really, really cannot. I'm stoked to finish it every single time. Even if you don't need the material or the, legendary fragments for a whole set or a whole piece at the end, you don't really need it, but it does unlock the pop-up for a lot of people. So it's beneficial right there. And of course, the 250% army expansions are fantastic. That's a lot of gems worth of items in that. Easy purchase in my mind. $5 isn't that much. Okay, let's go in to commanders. I obviously have Alex here. I don't think I'm going to change anything. I think the shield is still good enough for light versus dark. I don't see the need unless I get Sakura specialized, maybe, but I don't think I'm going to be forging one of those unless I really don't think so. I think I'd rather just stick to refining these, to be totally honest. Yes, it costs a bit of gold, but the stats you get from it are fantastic. I am hoping for Shio's Boots or Eternal Knight Pants or the Hope Cloak from Crystal Keys. If I get that, it would be phenomenal. Then I can put an iconic crystal in there because I have 2. And that would be great because I have no other legendary gear. We will go over which commanders I'm going to use. Obviously, with Light versus Dark, you don't have a whole lot of fighting except for in King's Landing, and then that fight can be anywhere from 4 hours to 12 hours to, I don't know, I haven't seen it longer than that. Either it's 4 hours or 12 hours. That's what I've seen in all the light versus darks I've done. I haven't done that many, but I've done, I think, three so far. So, not too many, but I do have experience in it. Obviously, I'll be using commanders like Richard with Aethelflaed. I always use that. I think it's a fantastic pair. Alex YSG is going to happen no matter what. I will be doing Charles and likely Joan to help buff my allies, or Charles and Bjorn. That's a good one too for the instant proc damage. What is it? This one? Nope. The last one right here. 800 damage factor. Really fun to see that pop off in murder balls when you're popping in and out. Really helps those reports. I will obviously be running Mina and probably Baybars. I did that in KvK Season 2 on this account. It was fantastic. It did really well. As long as you're not getting pulled into the murder ball and you're able to cast skills, you get so much AoE. It's fantastic. Squishy, very squishy. If you get surrounded, it's done. But you just have to be very agile. And if you've seen my other videos where I fight like this, it's very easy to control your marches. And the lag doesn't drag you into the murder ball. So stay tuned to the channel because I will show you more on that. I've got War most likely next weekend on my free-to-play account in 2563. So I'll show it there. And then also on this account, which will be coming up in a couple weeks. I'm sure we'll have the Ancient Runes or however the fights work. I think it's Ancient Runes and then Altar of Darkness is where you fight against the other kingdom. But let's go in now and open up these crystal keys. Cross our fingers. With the gold keys, we're trying to get Mehmed and Charles Martel. I think that's common for most people in my position. So let's do the gold keys first. Fingers crossed. Mulan would be good too, but I don't have her close enough to 5515 to use her in the field. That's like bare minimum. Otherwise, you do want her to be expertise. But 5515 isn't bad. And I did use it this KvK on my main behind Constantine. And it 100% helped my marches. And it actually got pretty decent returns. It was usually level, but it will, I guess, even with who I was attacking. But that's really good when you think about all the buffs and debuffs you're getting from Constantine and Mulan. Okay, let's open these up. Okay, we got some Tao Tao. I also needed, double C. Cao Cao, I always say it wrong, so I'll just say double C. Speed ups. Wow, 77 hours of speed ups. That's fantastic. Building speed ups, I'll be able to exchange into training speed ups, which I will 100% do because I'm not doing very many buildings these days. Stars are good to have. Obviously, the legendary stars. We've got some. I'll be able to trade these in. We're with the Ruined Crusader Fortress. So I'll be able to get legendary commander sculptures for these. Always good. Okay, so we got Mehmed, which is awesome. We only got 13 Mehmed, which is a bit of a bummer. We got 21 double C. And why am I not seeing any Charles Martel? Not even a single one. Ouch. How does that even happen? Not even a single Charles. I got Ragnar. I got a good amount of Mulan. I got 23 Mulan, which is pretty cool. I don't think that's even enough for another skill on this account, but it's nice to see. Oh no, sorry, I got 17. What am I talking about? Everybody can, you know, facepalm me for not seeing Charles Martel right there, but I guess he blended beside Freddy or El Cid. Man, I need to get used to these commanders. They look so different. Anyways, we didn't do too bad. I think I got a couple skills to do. So that's good. Let's just pop those in before we go any further. What do we got? So Charles Martel still, 26 away from another skill. If I get him at 5514, 5515 would be very cool. Obviously you want him expertised. You get more stats in defense, health, and the march speed is really what helps this commander a lot. Okay, double C, got another skill. Hopefully we can keep this going. I hope not to get it in whatever that's called. For barbarian damage. Hopefully we can get it in Tiger Knight or Lofty Ambition. That would be cool. Fingers crossed. Fail. It was doing so good. It would have been awesome to do 5-5. Don't even need to unlock the expertise. That would have been awesome, but oh well. Can't win them all and definitely didn't win them this time. What do we got here? We've got another Mulan. I do have them locked. Obviously, I want the 5515, so we'll just keep that locked. I got her at 5411 now. That's not bad, but not really usable. We got some more of her Queen Tamar of Georgia. I haven't finished all of these commanders yet, but as you can tell, we're getting very close to finishing all the epics. Now we've got Mehmet at 5-5, which is awesome. We are going to unlock him now. Where we go here. We're going to get him up to 4 stars so that I can have him at 5-5-1-1. He could be great behind Charles Martel. I've used him like that before. I actually used him behind Ramses on my main account. Awesome reports. Like, people do not expect to see Mehmet behind him, and with the relic included, my Ramses did very good. But let's get this commander up. That's going to get me to 3 stars, and then we'll quickly level him up. Oh, he's already, I've been doing so many barbs with him. He's already ready. Can we get this with, can we get that? Sweet. Okay, and we'll take these away, and we'll just do regular stars and keep those special ones for another day. Boom. 5-5-1-1. Gets that little extra troop capacity. I know it's only 2%, but having more troops on the field, it's like increasing all damage by that much. So it really does help. Wow, I've really done a lot of barbs on this commander because he's already ready to star up again. That's awesome. Skill-wise, honestly, I wouldn't pay too much attention to this. I've never used Mehmet as a primary commander in any format at all. I don't see the need to use him as a primary. I should have went one more, obviously, to rejuvenate, and then I would go over to fresh recruits for more troop capacity, but I wouldn't pay any attention to this at all because I don't use him as a primary ever. Did I get anybody else? Oh, Ragnar, yay. Look at that, Ragnar's at 5. That's great. Never will use this commander. I still haven't found him in open field to get some reports off of him. I'm looking for an expertise one in open field. Maybe one day I'll find him and I'll be able to see what he does and maybe PM the player and see if we can do a one-on-one just so I can see how he does. I don't think he's any good even with the relic. Just not a great commander. Oh, look at that. Just because I got him to level 40, I believe. That pops up. Did I get any goodies before I move on? Just in case I can get more keys. Nope. So we will go back in, get this quick silver key because they're free and it makes no sense to skip them. But here we go, 204. We have, I don't know what the odds are. Does it say what the odds are? Probability, legendary blueprints. We got less than 0.5%. So that's not great odds, but we have a decent amount of silver crystal keys. So you never know, we could get lucky. Hopefully we don't get everything but either Eternal Knight's Shiles Return or the Hope Cloak. But let's see. We didn't get a single one. Oh, that hurts. That many and we didn't get a single one. We got a lot of speed ups, which is good. We got a lot of material, which is nice. Looks like I'm going to be waiting for a material event like Archaeological Dig. That could get me the Hope Cloak. But man, that is rough. I've gotten better from like 50 crystal keys before. Ouch. But I did get a Kerak's Humility, so maybe I can get that talented. You know, that would make it worthwhile. But that really stinks. Okay, let's go in here. Let's refine this. I know I have one. So hopefully we can get lucky. 75. Not bad at all. One more and I'll be able to specialize that. That will help a lot. For every other commander, I need more. You know what? I probably actually should have just crafted Kerouac's Pants for Charles Martel instead of having this attack. But we will do that next time we get the Pants or Eternal Knights. Would be even better. And then I can just put Kerouac's Pants on Charles Martel. Richard, what does he have? Nothing fantastic. I definitely need to refine this one. Absolutely, because it's almost done. So we will do that. Infantry, confirm. Just buffing up my marches, getting them ready. I'm going to do that on this just because it's so close. It's not a lot of gold, doesn't cost any material, and now I've got 8% attack to Richard, which people usually ignore anyway, so attack's not too bad on Richard. At least that's what I've found. So we got Charles Martel, obviously needs some work. My main focus is going to be buffing up Alex to make sure he's the best. I would rather get ancient stratagems than wind scars, but once we get the dig event, I'll be able to change that up, I have no doubt. With Minamoto, man, I need more accessories. Hopefully we can get another holiday event coming up where you can get one of those epic choice chests for accessories. That would be great. I definitely need Delaney's. I know Silent Trial is very good to have, but I've already got two. I could definitely use Delaney's, at least one or two of those. Legendary accessories are kind of out of the question for this account. They're just so expensive that saving up for it would be very difficult. Hopefully one day in the future I can do that, but for now, it's just not an option. I can't do this. No, we need five for Witch's Lineage to be finished. But who knows, maybe I can do the Infantry Helm in the future with one of the events. But that's about it. This account, I really wish I had gotten some legendary equipment from that Crystal Keys, but we'll just have to wait until one of the events come up and use our gems. Now we don't have a lot of gems. We've got 34,000. On the last More Than Gems, I actually bumped up to VIP 12, which is great. I get two legendary commander sculptures a day, which is really going to help with building up my YSG to expertise. That's obviously the next goal. So I will continue pushing that. Hopefully get some good rewards from this KvK. Get the holiday event finished, which is going to give me another skill to YSG. Where is that Bunny Bonanza? So yeah, we'll keep working this. We'll get that finished. We'll get 15 more commander sculptures. We'll keep working this account. I've got quite a few speed ups I need to use. Obviously, I could use more. Once we get into KvK, I'll be able to exchange a lot of these, so I'll have more. And then obviously saving a lot of speed ups. I've got a good amount of speed ups on this. And healing speed ups. I got a decent amount of healing speed ups too. So I'll be able to do a lot of field fighting on this account. I've got a lot of resources, so it should be a lot of fun. But that's it, guys. Again, not so lucky today. My luck has been terrible. Hopefully, well, let's quickly run out for these. Hopefully I get luck in the future on CPO wheel. I don't know if you guys saw, but on my main account, the what's the other guy's name? Not CPO. We'll quickly jump over there and just take a look. This is sweet. This is infantry. We can send Alex. And then on this last one, it is again, we'll just send, I don't want to send Mina and double C just because, where is he? CPO, send as many as I can just because I want to launch a rally as soon as I get back. But we'll quickly jump over to my main and snap there and I'll show you. The Mightiest Governor event, which is actually cavalry, has the infantry commander in it. We've seen something like this before when new commanders come out. So that is what it is. But if you go into it at the very bottom, boom, there he is. Flavius Aetius is here. He is going to be available very soon. In 6 days, 18 hours, Mightiest Governor will start and you'll be able to fight for him. Hopefully get that commander. I definitely want to unlock him. I don't think I'm going to work him, but if you jump into here, now the P beside CPO 2.0, I do not know what that means. I really don't. It doesn't give you any information on, it doesn't say like anything special about him. I don't know what it means. I don't know if it means he's a rebranded like power commander. I don't know what the P stands for. P, I don't know. P is just so strange. It maybe if it was a 2 beside it, then you could be second generation CPO. Okay, I can understand that, but I don't understand what the P is for. So leave a comment down below if you know. I will be working this commander. We know he comes from the wheel. We all figured he was going to come from the wheel. I'll be spinning that to 100 each time. 100% having him expertise for our next KvK. Flavius, I don't think I will work. To be honest, I don't think I'll even get a spot in this upcoming MGE. My contributions will be high, but I'm going to go for most likely, if I'm going to get a spot in Mightiest Governor, it's going to be for Pakal. Like, really, I'm not a garrison commander, and this, sweet that I got the crystal and the gold key there. This commander is, I believe, a garrison commander. And I won't be working him. Yeah, garrison commander. I have no plans on being a garrison player anytime soon. So I don't think I will be working him at all unless videos come out showing that he's awesome in open field, which he very well could be. We'll have to see what testing comes up with. But right now, I don't have any plans to work him. And I don't think this MGE in 1937 is going to be set because we're still kind of fighting. And I imagine the enemy will come out on kill event and push just in a way to get points. So I don't know if they're going to set it. Maybe they are. Honestly, don't know. But we'll see what happens. Anyways, guys, that's this video. Well, we reached 21 minutes. That's pretty sweet. Until next time, have a good one. I will live stream as soon as there's an opportunity to. I don't really like live streaming unless there's something going on. Maybe if the wheel comes up soon and I'm available, I'll just live stream it. But I know next week we will likely have war in my free-to-play account in 2563 for KvK Season 1. If it works out, and I've already warned the wife, I will live stream it and we'll shoot for, you know, 6 to 8 hours like we do most times when there's war. So until next time, guys, have a good one. I hope you had a good long weekend. I know I did. I have tomorrow off. I'm excited about that. That's my last day off and then back to reality. But anyways, guys, have a good one. Talk to you later. Bye.